ocean and sky. Can you fly and sail as well as you drive? What is next in line? You're going to need a boat to access the first event. Use the fast bait vehicle switch and onward tow, sailor. The championship is about to begin, and it'll start with the powerboat race around smaller islands of the archipelago. You can use this short joyride to get better acclimated to your boat. Once the race is on, you will want to know what you're doing. This a do-over. Is yours for the taking.
this is Bob Schwartz. We're talking to you live from Hawaii, where we'll be following yet another Motor Fest series. A very special one, to say the least.
Indeed, no rubber or asphalt today. The competition you're about to follow is all about boats and planes. Ocean and sky.
Waves and wind.
That's right. And as you happen to be the boat specialist, Bob, the floor is all yours.
Thanks, Sean. Indeed, we're starting right off the bat with some serious inshore powerboat racing. The ocean is nice and flat, perfect for our competitors to show us how well they can handle these speedsters. If they use their trim right, they'll be able to push their machines to their maximum.
These things are fast, man. And I'm especially curious about that red Trident-shaped boat right there. What model is that?
This peculiar one-seater, my friend, is another unique MotorFest creation. A compact yet aggressive speedboat, the Water Rocket. Funny that this specific boat caught your eye. Its pilot is actually one of the newcomers who's recently been rocking MotorFest.
Interesting. Well, I guess we're not letting this promising challenger out of our sight then. Person here, but I have to admit, this series is off to a good start. I see a lot of skills down there.
You're absolutely right, Sean. Plus, we've got Hawaii on its Sunday best. Careful, it may not last.
Finish line. Hang in there, buddy.
That's Water Rocket, Sean. Try to keep up. We're off to a beautiful start. I didn't have my morning coffee, but with this kind of show, I don't think I'll need one.
Excellent warm-up, Bob. Now, let's fly.
Great job, but the journey is far from over. You've experienced the ocean. Now it's time to take to the skies. This is an opportunity to see the island like you've never seen before. Everything, everywhere, all at once. plane is ready for takeoff. The Beechcraft Model 17 Staggerwing, a historical biplane from the 1930s. That oldie's an all-time classic. It's not gonna let you down.
This is Bob Schwartz and Sean Babalu. What's up, Sean?
All good here, Bob. The first airborne trial has started, as you all know. These are individual races against the clock, and we're currently following our standout contestant from earlier. Come on, Water Rocket. Show them what you got.
Well, it truly brings a tear to my eye to see you so enthusiastic, Sean. You sound like you've just hit your 40s again. What's your feeling on this?
The weather conditions still seem reasonable, allowing our pilots to take advantage of these nice wind currents without any real turbulence. I'm really curious to see how the up-and-coming Water Rocket will take advantage of that. Let's see how it'll turn out.
Do you really think the newbie stands a chance in this competition?
Trust me, Robert, I can feel it in my bones.
One more time.
As you can see, some of the risky segments here require flying real close to the mountains. Is now following the ridge of the mountain.
A great spot for motocross. Off-roading addicts, this is for you.
And welcome to Hawaii. Good Beechcraft Stagger Wing is truly a beautiful piece, isn't it? And a great choice for that flight. If you take a look at its side, you'll notice that it bears an unusual negative wing stagger design, which means its upper wing is positioned behind the lower one.
A matter of visibility, I presume.
You're absolutely right, Bob, among other things. Watch closely, everyone. You don't see such a hot antique going all out like this every day.
Honolulu just appeared on the horizon. Oh, that's a great sight.
Here we are. This flight ends above the breathtaking Motorfest playground. A great time for the Stagger Wing and its promising pilots.
Well, I'm staggered.
Well done. Let's move on to the following event. Now that you've seen both sides of this playlist, you know what you got yourself into. The championship is on, and the next event is just a few minutes south of here. You'll be getting back in the water for a powerboat race that will take place around the stunning Hanama racetrack. Since you'll be surfing around the Alpha GP's turf, this obviously calls for a fitting boat, right? Don't worry, we got you covered with the Ice Marine Blade Runner. Don't forget to trim your boat in the straight lines to gain extra speed. We'll be right back.
is over. We're entering the second round. Same contestants, new waters, new boats. Bob?
I'm reared up and ready to go, Sean. The pilots are already giving it all. First, the contestants have to go along the racetrack water bridge.
It's like...
That race is not going to be easy. Lots of shallow water sections to cross and many obstacles to avoid. That's quite a different lineup that we have here compared to our first aquatic ride. We're going bigger, faster, meaner.
Some contestants, man, I can see that. Check out this boat. It looks like it's calling for blood.
The Ice Marine Blade Runner 35. British origins, extremely slick design, a boat that catches the eye.
Careful with the rocks.
Going up river now, things are going to go differently. Shallow waters, narrow paths.
Naomo Racetrack, and that's one lap.
Second lap. There's everything left to play for. A quick shout out to our friend and colleague Ray Waller, who's hosting the equally remarkable motorsports series just nearby at the Naomo Racetrack.
A real professional. I can almost hear him from here.
The jump. Absolutely. It kind of reminds me of that trip I took in Barbados with my wife Giselle about 20 years ago. Runner 35 in all its glory. I love that boat. I actually think I should get one.
Well, Bob, I'm not sure Giselle would agree with you on that.
time to rest on your laurels. Keep going, driver. The competition continues. Let me gather the new data. Done. Time to go to the skies again. For this new flight, you're going to need sharp reflexes and real steady nerves. Through the canyon, through the city, and more. Low altitude, high pace, and a whole lot of things to avoid. Extreme focus is mandatory here. Plane, the Civco Edge will be ideal for that ride, but it's not going to fly itself, so you're up.
should have seen the colors in that thing. And those custom designs, whew, real masterpiece. No joke, this bake-off season finale was a real... Hello, we're back live. Welcome back, everyone.
Hey, Sean, we're back indeed for our second air trial, where another contestant has just taken off. Several pilots already had their turns, so we're well suited to tell you that this path is a toughie. Right, Sean?
Well, Bob, you said it. We're talking about a low-altitude aerobatic flight through the canyon and other fun stuff. Highly technical and dangerous. Good luck out there, Water Rocket.
Mean suction right there. The more I see it, the more I think it must be hard to handle.
Yeah, MotorFest sure isn't sparing these pilots. And believe me, they're clearly not out of the woods yet.
Look at this guy, cleverly teasing what's coming next.
Above the lovely Hawaiian countryside.
Lovely, sure, but better watch for these wind turbines.
We'll be right back. powerful performance. It's incredible what a Zivco Edge and great skills can achieve.
Man and machine working in unison.
Driver, new challenges lie ahead. This is half time. You've earned a short break. The powerboat adventure about to join now stretches along the whole northern coast of the island, from east to west. There aren't as many turns over there, so it'll be like sailing offshore. I could tell you that maintaining your speed and keeping your opponents at bay is all you need to do. But you'll have to deal with choppy sailing conditions. It was just a matter of time. Did you really think you were going to avoid the Hawaiian curls forever? The good thing is, your boat for this race will be the Lamborghini Technomar. I know, this keeps getting better, doesn't it? Close. Don't forget, go fast, but watch for those mean waves. One single move can turn the tide.
Ready for that third round of Ocean and Sky. The race has started, and the eight boats are already making their way out of the bay. Of live broadcasting, my compadre, Mr. Babalu, is being kept elsewhere at the moment. But we're nothing if not adaptable, so let's move forward until he catches up. This time, we're going offshore with way bigger boats, including the incredible Lamborghini Technomar. You heard it, a boat made by Lamborghini, inspired by their astonishing Lamborghini Sean. And fellas, look at this Kraken! It's also important to mention that the sea got a little turbulent since the previous race. The competitors will have to deal with that. That's swell. Ooh, someone who's never experienced it can't fathom what it's like to sail in such conditions, especially at that speed.
Hey, everyone, it's Sean, and I'm back to the studio with my man, Bob. What did I miss?
Well, my friend, we're halfway through the race, and the weather conditions are only getting worse.
I can see it. I mean, look at these waves. Choosing larger boats clearly was the wise choice for this race.
Contestants need to push their engines.
Come on, water rockets. We made it. And our Challenger handled that gorgeous Lamborghini Technomar like a true sailor. Way to go, Water Rockets!
You know what? I think I'm also taking a liking to this newcomer.
Well done. Let's move on to the following event. You're going to need a plane that is both sturdy and maneuverable for what's coming. You'll be flying above the volcano through rough conditions. That's why we have another 20th century legend waiting for you. The Grumman F8F Bearcat, a real fighter. If you're going to look down on the volcano, that plane is your best ally.
Listeners, we're still on, and after quite a rough powerboat ride, it looks like Hawaii is set on making things difficult for our competitors.
That's right. After dealing with a pretty choppy sea, our pilots now have to cope with difficult flying conditions. Don't get fooled by this beautiful sky. Some serious turbulence is to be expected. Just hope that volcano doesn't have an extra surprise in store for us down there.
Airplanes, volcanoes, and turbulence. Sounds like a good old direct-to-DVD movie.
Hold on to your seat. It's time to gain altitude. speak, our favorite Challenger water rocket is back in the sky for this third flight. In the cockpit of a stunning Grumman F-8F Bearcat, or simply the Bear. An extremely reliable machine, it has served many purposes back in the day. Combat, aerobatic, air racing, or leisure.
The stories this plane could tell.
For sure. If that thing could speak, you would not be disappointed. He's the master of the island.
The big old Fire Mountain.
Look at this. How crazy is that?
Motorfest crazy. Talking about the plane, aren't you, Sean?
Congratulations, driver. On to the next one. Made it to the final part of the championship. Just two more events to go to settle the score in both disciplines. Everything you've learnt over the six previous rounds will be key to snatching the last points that could lead you to the podium. With the ultimate water showdown, a race among ships and carriers in the beautiful bay of Pearl Harbor. For this, we have a gleaming DCP M31 being prepped for you as we speak. An all-rounder, chosen to get you through all possible situations. No pressure, but quite a crowd has come to see this. What can I say? Your contestants are the stars.
everyone. We're now in Pearl Harbor Bay, and the contestants are already sailing at full speed. John, this is it, the final round of this series.
You're right, two events to go, starting as usual with an encounter at sea.
Look at this light, Sean. The day is young and promising, just like this race.
The ocean has calmed down, but this doesn't mean there isn't any less action. Our drivers out there must be filled with adrenaline and renewed vigor, as these are the last moments to score those final precious points.
You're totally right. These guys are going to play every single card they have. Trimming, nitro, and the best of their sea knowledge. The shallow water section.
Careful, the passage gets pretty narrow below these bridges. I'm checking on my number one contestant, Water Rocket, who's about to enter its second lap.
I'm with you on that. This time, our pilot got a DCB M31, an excellent, reasonably sized performance catamaran. Not as impressive as the Technomar, but way more suitable for that kind of technical inshore showdown. Going all around the aircraft carrier. Look at that massive ship.